लेट्स विल स्टार्ट आवर सेकंड सेशन फर्स्ट चैप्टर एलिमेंट्स ऑफ मल्टीमीडिया। सेकंड एलिमेंट विल स्टार्ट ऑडियो। ऑडियो मीन्स साउंड। साउंड इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट एलिमेंट ऑफ मल्टीमीडिया। वी कैन डिफाइन साउंड एज अ मीनिंगफुल स्पीच इन एनी लैंग्वेज। इट टर्म साउंड इज यूज्ड इन द एनालॉग फॉर्म एंड द डिजिटाइज्ड फॉर्म ऑफ द साउंड इज कॉल्ड ऑडियो। टेक्स्ट एंड इमेजेस विदाउट एनी साउंड आर हेल्पफुल व्हेन वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ द ऑडियंस, बट इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ प्रेजेंटर साउंड प्लेज एन इम्पोर्टेंट रोल। द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल इज when we are viewing an educational CD, the user can enable or disable the sound option, but the learning process is more enjoyable when it is played with sound. To make such kind of multimedia presentation, we need to first record the voice and play it according to the animation in the presentation. Thus, when a user sees the presentation, he or she is able to understand it easily by seeing the animation along with the voice. The live example is just now we are watching the video. Okay, in that text form is there and audio is also there. You are able to listen the sound or audio. That is the best example. Nowadays, computers support multimedia applications. They come along with required hardware and software needed for multimedia applications. We get inbuilt sound card, speaker, microphone and web camera, which are required for multimedia applications. The operating system provides application that can be directly used for capturing audio and video. Nowadays applications are available which is helped to record your voice as well as the video. Let us have a look at an audio recording application provided in Ubuntu Linux. Be sure you have microphone and speaker connected to the computer. Let us record our voice using the application by following the steps given. Now the steps are given. Select applications, then select sound and video, then click on sound recorder. These options, a sound recorder application will be shown in the figure. Here you can see this is sound recorder application. Choose the file new, click on the file and then new option. Use the record as drop down list to select one of the following recording option: CD quality loss or voice. To start recording, choose control record or click on the record button. You can see here this record button, or you can click on the control and then record button will be there. Now start recording the voice. For example, describe a tourist placed of Gujarat for our multimedia presentation on Gujarat tourism. Okay. You can see here recording process, it is showing. To stop recording, choose control, then stop or click the stop button. This button is available. You can click on the stop button to stop the recording. To play back the recording, whatever sound you record, voice you recorded, if you want to listen it, click on the control and play or directly play button. To run the audio mixer, choose file, open volume control. Okay, if you want to change or edit the sound quality, you can click on the volume control. To save the recording, choose the file save as and type the file name. You can save the file, click on the file and then click on the save button, type the file name, choose the location where you want to save it. We can also make changes to this sound file, like delete a part of it, change the playback speed, change the playback volume, and add echo, etc. Means some effects are there, or if you want to edit, cut, copy, that also you can do with your file. Multimedia elements can, like sounds or videos, are stored in media files. To discover the type of media file, we should look at the file extension. The commonly used audio formats are described in table. When you are using the sound file, audio file, different types of files available, and how you can see or identify which type of file is there. So by using the extension, you can identify the type of the file. Here MIDI file, okay, musical instrument digital interface. Okay, the extension of MIDI file is MID or MIDI. Okay, after the file name, 3 or 4 characters are there. It is called extension file name, then .mid or .midi, .rm or .ram. Read audio file. .wav means it is called wav file. .wma Windows Media Audio file. .mp3, .mpga, .mp3 is very commonly used file, mp3 what we are using for the listening the musics. .wav is the most popular uncompressed sound format on the internet, and it is supported by all popular browsers. The .mp3 is the new compressed format for recorded music. So if you want to use the recorded music, .mp3 is the best choice. Commonly they are using .mp3. Now third one is image. Image means picture. Generally multimedia presentations are graphics image based. Information communicated through images is easier to remember and understand. Images used in a multimedia application can be photographs converted into digital form with the help of scanners or generated on the computer. Computers stored the pictures in the form of pixels. Maps, also known as bitmap or raster image. A picture, short form of picture element, is the small dot on the screen. A map is a two-dimensional matrix of the dots. Thus, a bitmap is a simple matrix of tiny dots which forms an image on the computer screen. Each pixel contains values representing a color. When an image is sent to be displayed on the screen, the picture data is converted to pixel. Pixel means it is one dot. Whenever you are able to see any images, it is form of dot. So many dots are there. How many pixels are there? Okay, means more pixels are there, then resolutions will be high. Another form of image generated by computer is vector graphics. They store the images in the form of mathematical equations. On the screen, both bitmap and vector graphics looks the same. But when you enlarge the bitmap image, it will blur and the pixels will get enlarged as shown in the figure 1.10. The vector images, on the other hand, looks the same when enlarged. This is because the data is stored in the mathematical form and the values are recalculated when displayed on the screen. Here you can see this is bitmap image and this is enlarged bitmap image showing the pixels. Okay, means when you are zooming the images, okay, we can see in the mobile also, when you will zoom it, any image, any picture, whichever is captured, okay, so you can see it is looking like a blur, means it is showing the pixels. Both the types of images are stored in different file formats as mentioned in table 1.2. Typically, these files are compressed to save memory space. Bitmap image file formats like GIF, JPEG, and PNG use compression within the file itself. The commonly used image formats are described in the table. This is file extension .bmp bitmap image uncompressed file used to store bitmap digital image. Whenever you are drawing any images with the help of paint, the extension of that file will be .bmp. GIF, graphical interface, interchange for file format file, common for the web graphics use, small images and images with text. Next one is PNG, portable network graphics. Next one, .jpeg or .jpg, very commonly used file format for the images. Joint photographic expert group image file. .psd, Photoshop document, when you are creating file with the help of Photoshop application, it will be stored with the extension .psd. .tif, tagged image file format. Using inbuilt images in a common practice while preparing a presentation. For example, in OpenOffice Writer, we can insert a picture. By going to insert picture, the picture use can be a file already present in the computer, or we can scan the picture using scanner and convert it into digital format to be used further by the computer. Figure 1.11, so the document with an image inserted using OpenOffice Writer, it is similar to Microsoft Office Word. OpenOffice Writer is an application, we can say it is word processing application, okay, which we are using Microsoft Office Word, both are similar. The image used in figure 1.11 was already available to us. We may use any other image of our liking. We can also make changes to our images by using programs like Adobe Photoshop, GIMP, MS Paint and others. These are the applications available to change, to make changes in the images, like suppose you want to change the color resolution. Okay, so with this applications, Adobe Photoshop, GIMP, MS Paint, it can be helped to make changes in your image. Next one, element, video and animation, which is most important. Animation can add great power to any multimedia application. Any static presentation becomes lively by adding a video or animation. Just now also we are using the presentation. Whatever I am explaining with the picture, you can see here text is there, it is in the form of picture. But suppose I will apply the animation, so it's become more interactive or effective. It is, we can say this is static. Why? Because no any effects are given, animations are given. Okay, here whatever you are looking, that is called static presentation. Let us first differentiate between animation and video. The term video refers to the sequence of natural scene captured using analog or digital video capturing device. This device can be a web camera, digital camera or even mobile phones. Animation is a visual change over time. What is the difference between video and animation? So animation means it is different effects are given or visual effect given to the picture, that is called animation. The digital images are played one after the other to create or moving effects. We can say that animation is created from drone pictures, and video is created using real-time visual. Carefully planned and well-executed video clips or animations can make a great difference in multimedia applications. Some examples of animations are movies like Kung Fu Panda and Smurf. These are the examples of the animation. Cartoons, which you are looking the cartoons on the television, that is also the examples of animations. Animations can be classified as two dimensions, means 2D, or three dimensions, 3D. In 2D animation, the visual changes occurs on the X and Y axis of the screen. This type of animation is simple. Some examples of 2D animation software are Macromedia Flash, Synfig Studio and Pencil. In 3D animation, the visual changes occurs along three axes, namely X, Y, and Z. This type of animation gives almost a realistic view of the image as can be seen by the human eye. Some examples of 3D animation software are Maya, Blender, and 3D Max. Figure 1.12 shows the view of an object in 2D animation software, and figure 1.13 shows the view of an object in 3D animation software. We will learn how to create animation in later chapters. Here you can see 2D object, and here you can see it is 3D object. Let us now see how to record a video using VLC Media Player. VLC Media Player can use to record the video also. It is essential that you have VLC Media Player installed in your computer. It is application and it should be installed if you want to use it. If not, then download it from Ubuntu Software Center. It is a free open source media multimedia player. Free open source means it is available on the internet free. You don't have to pay for it. You can install and you can use it. Be sure you have webcam connected to the computer. If you want to record a video, then it is necessary that web camera should be connected to your computer. Let us start recording video by following the steps. Here steps are given that how you can record a video with the help of VLC Media Player. First, open VLC Media Player. Select media, then click open capturing device. This will take you to the open media dialog as shown in the figure 1.14. Select the video device name and audio device name. Okay, from here you can select the video and audio device, whichever device are connected to your computer, the device you have to select. Note, the device name and the audio device name may vary as per the setting of reader's machine. In case you have multiple devices, you can choose the one that you would like to use. If you have more than one device, okay, you have to use one. From the play drop down menu visible in the open media dialog box of figure 1.14, select convert option. This will open a convert dialog box as shown in figure 1.15. In the text box after destination file label, select the destination and file name. Okay, so you have to choose the location and the file name. Check display the output. You have to click on the display the output checkbox to see what you are recording, means it will show what you are recording. Click on the start button to start recording. Now, figure 1.16 shows the video recording progress. Click the stop button. Okay, here you can see it is showing the preview of recording. Now, to stop, click on the stop button to stop the recording. Later, the recorded video can be attached to the multimedia application. You can also try out another open source video recording software called Cheese Webcam Booth, available in Ubuntu Software Center. It is also one application it will use to record the video. The commonly used video formats are shown in table 1.3. Here some video files are available. The extension .avi, .wmv, .mpg, .mpeg, .mov, .rm, .ram, .swf, .fly, .mp4. Commonly used the video files are .avi and .mp4 or .mpeg. These are the commonly used. Here .swf and .fly. Okay, it is flash file which generally used to create the interactive or for the teaching purpose, okay, learning series, learning objectives they are using. Today MP4 is the most widely used format for the internet video. It is supported by Flash Players, YouTube, as well as HTML5. So here we will stop. We will meet in the next session. Thank you.